Welcome to Growing Graph, friends. This side Sonia here, and today we are going to alter a photo frame and create a nice centerpiece decor. But before we start this tutorial, do not forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for all the latest updates. So now, to start with this project, I had got a bunch of frames recently online and I thought of converting it into a beautiful centerpiece tray. Now here I have this tissue paper which I have used earlier for one of my cutlery holder project, and I was left with a small portion. Now I'm going to cut this into a size and I am going to cover the entire frame with this one. In the center I'm marking it with a pencil and then I'm going to cut it so that I can just remove the extra portion, and I'm going to use this for the base, which you will see at the mid of the project. And now I'm going to cut this and remove all the pliers and stick it well to my base. Before doing anything, I need to color my base, and here I'm using white acrylic color. I will be doing good 2-3 coats of acrylic paint so that my white color really brightens up. And in the mid of this, I'm also going to use my heat gun to speed up the drying process. My paint work is absolutely done. Now here I'm removing the ply off my tissue, and this was super quick this time and I'm happy about that. Now with the help of my Mod Podge, I'm going to stick this well on my base. For this I'm using my paint brush, and I'm going to first stick the top layer of my frame, and then I'm going to stick the sides and the corners of this frame with my decoupage tissue. Making side is super easy. Like the way you had applied the Mod Podge on the top, apply the Mod Podge on the sides also and stick it. You can always cut off the extra papers. I'm just going to stick it as much as I can, and I'm going to just fold it and cut the extra portions at the end, of course. ticking work of my base is done, and now this is the frame, the inner portion of the photo frame, and I'm going to stick this with the leftover piece of my cutting. Yes, this is the one which I had cut in the center of my picture decoupage napkin. Now here I'm going to stick this with my Mod Podge again. Whenever I do my decoupage, I always make sure that I have my sponge dauber, my plastic sheets around, so that as and when I need them to stick my projects, I do it really well. Because sponge dauber and your plastic sheets and your dry flat paint brushes are the perfect tools to stick your decoupage napkins really well to your project. And as you can see here, it's looking really, really cool, and I'm happy with the way it has turned out. Centerpiece without the shiny material was looking so dull, so I thought of adding some mica flakes to it, and here I'm using my Mod Podge again and I'm going to stick it. This is the first time I'm using mica flakes. I've never ever used it, so I thought it will be a good trial for me also. And trust me, my project looks really amazing in person the way it has turned out. Now here, once I'm done with applying my Mod Podge, I'm going to stick these mica flakes on complete surrounding of my frame. Once I'm done with the first layer of my mica flakes, then I'm going to apply again my Mod Podge, and then again I'm going to have my second layer of mica flakes on where are the areas I have left out. And with this, my project is completely done. Yes, I did added the varnish at the end off camera, because once my Mod Podge dries out, then only I can do my varnish. And my project is done with this, and I hope you all enjoyed this tutorial. I'm listing down all the supplies down in the description box. Do check that. If you have any queries, please do comment below. I'll try to help you as much as I can. And do not forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you so, so, so much for watching. Take care. Bye-bye.